Good morning. Today is Thursday, March 3rd, 2016. I'm Kurt Owen. Mitt Romney isn't running for president, but he is attacking Donald Trump. We have the details.
And I'm Chris Ivey. Ben Carson, once a leading candidate, is giving up. We have the story. Your citizen news starts now.
Security will begin issuing new parking tickets this week. These tickets are the same type that city police and highway patrol use that have to be scraped off your window with a razor blade. Please get your student parking pass in the next couple of days and park in the correct spots so security does not have to put you in one on your vehicle.
Men and Tights Volleyball Tournament will be Wednesday, March 9th at 5 o'clock p.m. in the NHS Main Gym. Players need to arrive by 5:45 p.m. and Sports Club members, please arrive at 4 o'clock to set up. All payments and waivers must be turned in prior to the tournament start. Come and watch the fun for $3 or bring two cans of food and watch it for only $1. Melissa Gross will be selling Men and Tights t-shirts to help raise money for summer volleyball camp. Please see her or Opal if you're interested in purchasing one. Cost is $12. Order now. Pickup will be on March 9th at the event.
The yearbook staff is selling space for you to give a personal shout out to your favorite person on campus. Maybe you and your friend have an inside joke or you've always wanted to profess your love for someone special. You can place a message in the yearbook that will surprise them at the end of school year. You can purchase your shout out after school in room 201 and Ms. Levi for $10 each with a 140 character limit.
The annual NHS Talent Show sponsored by Project Graduation will be this Friday, March 4th. Plan now to attend and see our school's awesome talent. The cost is $5, general admission, or $3 for students with ASB cards.
Upward Bound students are selling Mexican candy to raise money for club activities. If you are interested in getting some, please find an Upward Bound student or Miss Similia.
The science team is holding an Italian dinner silent auction fundraiser tomorrow in the cafeteria. Tickets are $10 per person or $30 per family of four. Talk to Mr. Anderson or any science team member if interested.
National English Honor Society is having a yard sale on Saturday, March 12th from 8 p.m. to 5 p.m. on NHS 12 Avenue. Front lawn and any donations are gladly accepted and may brought to Mr. Puckridge classroom in 656. Put the 12th on your calendar and plan to come shopping at their sale. Thank you for supporting the National English Honor Society. We'll be right back after this.
Today's weather is brought to you by Dr. Kim Keller. Your smile is your first impression. Make it a good one and visit Dr. Keller today. Today's high is 61 with a low of 37, mostly sunny. And tomorrow's high is a high of 64 with a low of 49, partly cloudy. Back to you.
Thanks, Chris. The Republican Party continues to squabble and fight as they pick a candidate for president. Today, Mitt Romney plans to launch a broadside against Donald Trump's surging campaign, calling a Trump a phony and a fraud who is playing Americans for suckers. The 2016 frontrunner is already firing back, calling Romney a failed candidate who begged him for endorsement when he ran 4 years ago. Romney claims the only serious policy proposals for the countries are coming from the other Republican candidates on the field.
Retired neurosurgeon Ben Carson said that he is effectively ending his bid for the White House Wednesday, concluding a roller coaster campaign that briefly took him to the top of a chaotic GOP field but ended on a Super Tuesday. "I do not see a political path forward," Carson said in a statement posted on his campaign website. Though he added, "I remain deeply committed to my home nation, America," and promised to offer details of his future when he speaks Friday at a conservative conference in Washington. Carson is not going to appear at tonight's Republican debate.
Today's SAT word of the day is accessible, which means able to reach, able to understood. Or you could use it this way: concerned that cultural events be accessible to all, the opera decided to drastically reduce the ticket price for some of its performances. Thank you for watching. Remember, if the news breaks,
we'll fix it.